Ladies and gentlemen, our following contest is brought to you by the Quiet Lion Creative. Fighting out of the blue corner, Curtis Smeaton.
Hey, I'm on vacation every single day because I love my occupation. Hey, I'm on vacation. If you don't like your life, then you should go and change it. Hey, I'm on vacation every single day because I love my occupation. Hey, I'm on vacation every single day, every single day.
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent fighting out of the red corner, Sing Tanoi, Simon Lunga. Ladies and gentlemen, your following contest is brought to you by the Quiet Lion Creative. 3x3 minute rounds in the super featherweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, trained by Josh Donahue at a ZMA Academy. Last night at the weigh-in, he came in at 59.25 kilograms. 18 fights, 9 wins, 9 losses. Fighting out of Newcastle, New South Wales, please welcome Curtis Smeaton. And across the ring is this man's opponent, fighting out of the red corner, trained by John Miller out of the Super Fight Gym. Last night of the weigh-in, he came in at 59.60 kilograms. Fight record of 5 fights, 3 wins, 2 losses. Fighting out of St Kilda in Melbourne, he is Sing Tanoi, Simon Lunga. Both fighters conceal the ring.
It's a super featherweight contest set for 3x3 minute rounds as Jordan Fielding brings in a 9-9 record, weighed in at 58.9 kilos. Simon Lunga brings in a 3-2 record, weighed in at 59.6.
Only 3 rounds, yeah. Okay, not foul. Okay, good luck, yeah.
Foul instructions from our referee, Tatakan Samatong. 3x3 minute rounds, full Muay Thai rules, knees and elbows in this super featherweight matchup. They touch gloves and we are underway. Simon Lunga in the red, Curtis Smeaton in the blue. In Lunga's corner, the thriller Don Miller, who, if Lunga wins this one, will have a clean sweep tonight of 3-0. Or will the party be spoiled by Curtis Smeaton? Southpaw stance on Smeaton, orthodox here for Lunga. Both men just tipping their toes in the proverbial waters. Good wind up of the right round kick there from Lunga. Fires out the front kick, didn't connect. High check, counter down the corridor with the right hand, Lunga. Jab two from Lunga. Nice sliding jab it was. Outside leg kick, Lunga. His reaction time, very fast, Simon Lunga. Smeaton, in true Thai style, very light on the lead leg.
Higher, higher, guys, do all higher.
Just a caution from the referee to keep the kicks either higher or lower away from the groin area. Forearms caught that one. Good wind up again though on the rear leg from Lunga. Once more trying to attack the left side of the body of Smeaton. A very calculated opening round so far for Simon Lunga.
That head kick just missed. I mean, Lunga's right leg is lightning speed. And we saw at the start of the round, Michael, that he was switching between orthodox and southpaw. We can see now that he's just changed up again.
Fake there from Lunga. Using the push kicks well in the opening round. High left round kick. Sticking to southpaw stance here, nice evasion. And he looks so calm, so relaxed, does Lunga. Nothing fazing him so far. That said, Smeaton still trying to find his range as Lunga climbs the ropes.
Great defensiveness there from Lunga. Showing excellent strategy here.
Lunga switching back to orthodox stance now. I do like him out of orthodox because it does enable that wicked right round kick he's got. He's so fast with it.
Absolutely agreed here, Michael.
We'll see if he pulls the trigger and goes to the left side of the body of Smeaton again. A fake there from Smeaton. Good extension of the front kicks from Lunga off both legs. Smeaton fakes out of his own southpaw stance. This really has been a filling out round for Smeaton in particular. And we go to the towels at the end of one.
This one brought to you by the Quiet Lion Creative. A big thanks to Little Soldiers.
And here we have it, the first round of action in this 59 kilogram category. Simon Lunga in the red, Curtis Smeaton in the blue, and Simon Lunga's right leg is an absolute bullet, moving at a trajectory that can't be seen by the naked eye. Curtis Smeaton managed to get a little bit of Simone's timing down, but as the first round ran on, it was all Lunga.
Round two, yes?
Round number two.
We're ready to rock and roll. Second round set for three. Early handiwork from Lunga, tagged him with that right. Opens up in southpaw stance. Did switch in the first. Front kick from Lunga. So many weapons at his disposal. And once again, sweat flies off the brow of Smeaton. Flying knee. Lunga has opened up like a house on fire here in the second. More knees to the battered right side of the body of Smeaton.
We've got the classic New South Wales versus Victoria. And a beautiful sweep there from Lunga.
You see the high IQ of Lunga. Coming off an impressive win at Hardcore 7 last October. Tom Miller giving few instructions. None really required because Simon Lunga is doing everything right so far. Smeaton goes the inside thigh. Parries the round kick.
I'm surprised at the amount of power that Lunga manages to conceal in the speed of those right leg kicks that he's firing away at Smeaton. Smeaton's copying them. Don't know if he's got the answer just yet to unlock the secret that has been Simon Lunga.
Switching stance, Lunga. Referee wants to see more engagement, particularly stop. From Smeaton. He's going to call time here and have a word with them.
Round two, yeah? Have to fight more, yes? Yeah? Chop! Come on,
Smeaton needs to step it up. Both men in southpaw stance. Oh. Hook off the lead hand, high right round kick, doubles up and it does. Make it in triplicate, make it four, five. Five round kicks off that right leg from Lunga.
He almost took mercy on him there, Michael. I mean, five shots in a row. There's another one. Stepped away and let Smeaton have a moment of peace.
Lunga trigger happy on the right leg tonight. Comes forward again. Nice little quarter angle turn. Smeaton needs to go first here.
Absolutely, Michael. Smeaton needs to initiate. He needs to land something and then get out of the way of the speed of Lunga. But I feel like his confidence has been shaken. And it continues to be shaken with every single shot that he coughs unanswered.
Smeaton's been enjoying throwing the three, but there's no two for company. If you throw the hook, he's got to follow through with the right hand. There's a flurry for Lunga. And the referee breaks them. Lunga seems to have his number at the moment. Switches back to orthodox stance, does Lunga. This is where he enables that right round kick. Good counter right hand, moves into the clinch, throws the knees off the left. Solid Muay Thai here from Simon Lunga. Two rounds to nil, we feel in favour of Simon Lunga.
Quiet Lion Creative. We are live at Hardcore Promotions. A big thank you to Supreme Precast.
World-class Muay Thai here tonight at Hardcore Promotions. Simone Lunga chasing down Curtis Smeaton. Here you can see them up against the ring, trading knees, trading sneaky little elbows, but it's been all Simone Lunga. Curtis Smeaton, really, really tough, keeps taking the punishment, but just doesn't seem to be able to fire off quickly enough, strategically enough, to quell the onslaught that is Simone Lunga. Of course, Simone Lunga being trained by the famous Don Miller out of Super Fight Gym. World-class standard. But Curtis Smeaton, no slouch from ZMA in Newcastle.
Oh, 3 minutes remains for Curtis Smeaton to try and find a solution to the riddle that is Simon Lunga. Nice knee guard from Lunga. Nothing getting through from Smeaton. He must be frustrated. He takes a deep breath, walks into another one of those beautiful teeps. Little quarter angle turn again from Smeaton off the hook, fakes the back leg. It's the subtleties of Simon Lunga you've got to look out for. Go back, folks. Watch this one almost in slow motion. Pause it, replay it over and over again. Because there is beauty in the fighting style of Simon Lunga. He is an artist painting a masterpiece in the ring at the moment. Smeaton doesn't commit. He cannot afford just to throw the single punches. You almost feel like he's got to bite down on the mouthpiece here, Nick, and just flurry on Lunga and see what lands.
You're absolutely right, Michael. I mean, if he doesn't throw caution to the wind now, then it is all for naught. He's been in there for two rounds. He hasn't had anything to show for it. He needs to pull it out here with a minute 45 left in this third and final round.
And Lunga's dancing. The confidence oozing.
You mentioned a masterpiece. I mean, it's just musical what this guy's doing here tonight.
The speed, the precision, the strike selection, showing that high IQ that Lunga's so renowned for. He's back in southpaw stance, perhaps his preferred stance. But when he wants to throw what's been his prime strike, he switches and uses that right leg roundhouse. Smeaton unable to change it up here.
It must be so frustrating for Smeaton, Michael. I mean, he's got good capability. Oh,
got a good jaw as well, as we saw there, a clean left hand landed by Lunga. And Smeaton is in that awkward no man's land where he's going to get teed off on like a golf course. You've either got to be out and throwing at range or completely in, inside the clinch, inside the pocket with Lunga. If you're in no man's land, he is going to fire on you. And that's what he's been doing for two rounds with 30 seconds to go in this third and final. Simon Lunga cruising towards a very comfortable decision. Unless Smeaton can find a miracle or hopes that a chandelier falls on the head of Simon Lunga. High left round kick, jumping knee, spinning back fist. Lunga puts on a show, a jumping roundhouse. The crowd loving it. And wherever you're watching around the country, we hope you're loving it. It's the Simon Lunga show. He has a very special talent, Nick.
Absolutely, Michael. Here we go to the replay, and there you see Simone Lunga firing away on Curtis Smeaton, and poor Curtis Smeaton. I mean, he's tough as nail, took some big shots, but just continue to have his confidence eroded moment after moment. Four syllables, two words, Simone Lunga. What this man doesn't know about Thai fighting, nobody needs to know.
I think we all know the result, but let's go to John Demacoli anyway to enter it into the record books.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of Muay Thai, we've gone to the judges' scorecards for a decision. We have a unanimous points decision with all judges scoring the contest. 30-27 to your winner from the red corner, Sing Pernoy, Simon Lunga.